Blackstone Audio presents Skeleton Picnic, a J.D. Books mystery, by Michael Norman. This book is read by Patrick Lawlor. Chapter 1. Friday Afternoon. Day 1. Irritated, Roland Rogers glanced at his watch. The retired Kanab high school teacher was anxious to get underway. Abby, his wife of 37 years, was late. He dialed her cell number at the supermarket.
"Hi, Rolly. Can't talk now. We're busy."
"You promised you'd get off early today. We need to get going."
"I tried. They won't let me off."
"If we don't get moving soon, it'll be dark before we find the site."
"I'm too busy to talk. Gotta go," said Abby. "I'll get there as soon as I can."
He started to argue, but she disconnected before he could say anything else. He closed the flip phone, muttering to himself. Rolly Rogers hooked the small pop trailer to the back of his Ford F-350 pickup. The massive 4x4 had almost unlimited towing capacity and had always gotten him through, no matter how difficult the terrain. The Silver Beast, as he liked to call it, looked just the same as when he'd driven it off the showroom floor 6 years earlier. Better, in fact. Shiny new chrome wheel covers decorated the tires. Rogers was a man who took good care of his things. Everything neat and tidy and everything in its place was a standard he lived by and had instilled in each of his children. He had already loaded the off-road vehicle into the truck bed. Now he only needed to add groceries and several tools for digging. And, of course, wait for Abby to get home. A third-generation Kane County resident and a lifelong pot hunter, Rogers grew up in a family that collected ancient artifacts from any place it could find them. Usually that meant public or tribal lands. It was illegal, sure, but everybody did it. As a kid growing up in the 50s and 60s, he recalled outings with family and friends where everybody collected whatever they could find. Pot shards, arrowheads, ceremonial blankets, beads, clay pots, baskets, even human bones. His grandfather referred to these weekend adventures as skeleton picnics. Collecting ancient artifacts was a family tradition in the Rogers household, one that he passed along to his own children as they grew, and an activity that had united the close-knit Mormon community of Kanab during good times and bad. His personal collection of Fremont and Anasazi antiquities rivaled that of anyone in southern Utah. While he would never admit it, selling valuable artifacts not only raised his standard of living, but also helped pay the cost of sending his children to Brigham Young University. This trip was the first of the year. Like most serious collectors, Rogers confined his artifacts hunting activities to the spring and fall months to avoid the blistering summer temperatures that turned the arid Colorado plateau into a high-altitude inferno of parched clay, sandstone, and granite. They left Kanab a couple of hours before dark, heading south along State Highway 89A until they crossed the Arizona state line near Fredonia. At Fredonia, they turned west on Highway 389 and followed it to the Paiute Reservation, then further west, deeper into the reservation, until they saw road signs for the Pipe Spring National Monument. Instead of entering the monument, Rogers turned south on a narrow, washboard dirt road that ran along the banks of the Colorado River until it eventually dead-ended at a recreation area called Toro Weep. Rogers had no intention of going that far south, so he turned east into a remote, sparsely populated area where he and Abby had stumbled upon an Anasazi site the previous fall. In less than a mile, the road disappeared, and Rogers found himself slowly picking his way around and through granite boulders, salt and sagebrush, cheatgrass, and misshapen sandstone pinnacles and buttes. A large-eared pinyon mouse darted in front of the truck, disappearing into a stand of isolated junipers.
"Think anybody discovered our little treasure?"
His wife looked genuinely bored.
"I doubt it. It's a pretty remote site, and we're so early in the season that most people haven't started hunting in earnest."
"I hope you're right."
When Rogers felt he could go no further without risking damage to the truck and trailer, he stopped and set up camp, not far from where he believed the site was located. Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.